Elegant could actually zero to death paper consistently, because right after he's out of that sweet spot range, and you know, it's very hard to combo Game & Watch just because he's so light.
I mean, on the reverse side of that though, like at his other combos, his down throw up B or down throw down B might kill super early too. But yet again, he can't utilize fireballs in neutral because Game & Watch will bucket that, and if he gets three of those, then like Game & Watch all of a sudden has like a 30 power move that kills.
Yeah, exactly. So we're gonna see a lot more Elegant utilizing the plunger actually to try to get in the short hop Zair plunger into grab, which gets a lot of players.
Yet again, trying to go for the ledge trump, not gonna find it. Gets punished for using the down B, and usually like that down B is a really good catch-all option just in case like they drop shield because it's invincible.
But I really like that from Paper. He knew that he was kind of in trouble, but Elegance's shield was very, very low, so he opted to kind of just press a little bit more buttons to be able to save himself from getting punished and just shield stabbing Elegant.
Right. And yet again,
oh,
there's
that's
that
such a smart get up option. He kind of waited for everything for Paper to do something first.
All right. And you know, it's one of those things where like you don't expect a character to have an invincible option as soon as they jump from ledge, you know? So it's one of those things where like if you're not expecting it and you get caught by it, then like you can just die super early.
Exactly. And Paper just trying to struggle, struggling a little bit for the edge guard, but finally gets the back air, beating out the Luigi Cyclone, even though it's supposed to be invincible.
Right.
I think I mean, it's because it's like, you know, a disjoint.
I feel like it's also like he got it before like the invincibility started up. But yet again, it's one of those things where like it's also a disjoint, yeah. So he might just hit him out of it.
Oh, trying to go for the judgment just to see if he could tie this game up super, super fast, because again, when you're losing, you're going to be the one that has to make plays, so you're going to have to take a lot more risks to try to catch up.
Right. And I love that use of up B to avoid getting grabbed right there, because you know if you got grabbed, it probably wouldn't have been death. Mm-hmm.
But just fantastic neutral coming out from these two players. Elegant trying to slow down the pace of the game, trying to check Game & Watch by utilizing the Toilet Plunger and some of the fireballs, but not, you know, overusing the fireball so he gets bucketed. And Paper just slowly coming in with these up Bs and these neutral Bs. And Paper finally breaking the neutral.
Right. And again, there's the up smash. Wow.
Wow, he fell out of Nair.
And you know what, like, how much awareness he had to have? It was like, yeah, if I'm going to fall out of this move, which probably shouldn't happen, I'm going to bear immediately. Like, Do you think like players like actively think in their mind like, yeah, I'm gonna fall out of this, I'm gonna bear, or do you think they're just trying to mash to get out of move and they just happen to hit the back air button?
No, they just have that good of reaction times, actually. They're just like, okay, let's see if I do it, and if I do it, I'm gonna hit it, and then they instantly react with that. But I really like that back air coming out from Elegant, and here's the first zero to grab.
Oh yeah. Oh no,
he barely misses it.
Yeah. Drifted a little bit too far forward for that re-grab.
Yeah, but Elegant saving his own life by drifting up a little bit to the right to avoid the back air. But Paper closing it out with a fantastic down air.
And yet again, now Game & Watch is at kill percent, so he has to be really careful about pretty much everything at this point.
Really smart coming in with that landing option with the Nair, because it's just so weird to try to punish Game & Watch on the landing when you really want to try to kill him. You have to, you know, really respect his landing option all the time. And good run-up forward smash. Paper accidentally utilizing a resource by throwing out that bomb right there to try to space it out. But because of that, he was in lag. And just Elegant was able to just capitalize on that.
And similarly, what you said earlier, you have to worry about when Game & Watch is up super high, because then they'll use down air. But conversely, when they're super down low, they're less likely to use it, because then they'll have more end lag on that move.
Exactly. You'll see them use a lot more forward airs and nairs, actually.
Right.
Depending on where you are, too. We're getting into game number two. Where did you see them go? Because I couldn't see.
I think they just ran it back, yeah.
Oh, run it. It's SoCal, baby. SoCal special.
Yeah. I mean, SoCal, this is pretty much like the new Starterville.
Yeah.
It's one of those stages where, like, I feel like it's the most balanced stage of all the stages, you know?
There's DK, though.
Okay. It's neutral for everybody except for DK. DK actually, like, destroys on this map. So, yeah. Like, if you ever fight a DK, never take him to Smashville. You'll regret it.
Oh, yeah. Also, if you're a DK main and you're thinking of moving out to SoCal, you will love it, because everybody's going to be like, oh, yeah, let's just go to SoCal. I don't care.
Yeah.
But getting into this, I really like how Paper is just keeping Luigi in disadvantage and really respecting when he's going to use his down B or his Nair, because those are very good get off me options to say like, oh hey, get out of jail free card. Your punish turns into my punish.
And I like what he used the up B for right there and the up smash yet again. But as I was saying, for the edge guard, you know, he can throw out the bears, and if he gets the bears, then like Luigi's dead. But if he misses it, then he can always just up B, and like because the up B is invincible on startup, like pretty much all the way up, you know, it'll hit Luigi before he can throw out a move, and it might kill him. But yet again, that's what I was talking about earlier, the down throw to up B right there. Game Watch is pretty much, he just can't get grabbed, because if he's at low percents, then like he gets zero to dead. If he's at higher mid percents, then it's down throw up B, and at like super high percents, it's down throw down B.
Ooh. Yelgin accidentally giving Paper all the bucket. Oh, he actually used it in that exchange while Elgin was still throwing out the plunger and fireballs.
Right. Maybe he thought that it wasn't fully charged, and so he was just trying to absorb it. But or maybe he thought he could just beat it out and just didn't come out in time. Because that move does have a little bit of startup to it.
Yep. And now this is going back to an even game. Paper was running away with it this first few minutes, but Elgin, being a top player for a reason, able to bring it back to even.
Right.
He's looking fantastic down smash to kind of just catch that.
Right. And I love that, using the up smash to counter the up smash. You know, it's one of those things where, like, when you have really good up smashes out of shield, like, you can't afford to hit them against the shield.
I use the up smash to beat the up smash.
Yeah. It really be like that sometimes.
Oh, wow. I use the down smash again.
Yeah. The first down smash didn't hit. Let's go for it a second time. He won't expect it the second time. I'm pretty sure if he didn't go for an option, then like he would have gone for it a third time. And that, by that point, if he didn't pick something, it would have killed because it would have just hit the ledge.
Can we just talk about how when Elgin lost that one neutral exchange, he instantly got to 69.9 off of just up airs and nairs and stuff?
Yeah.
Like, it's so hard for Luigi to land because, yeah, he has that invincible down B and he has the nair to make your combo his combo.
Right.
But it's still so hard to land if the other player has a disjoint, you know?
Right. And you know, like, Paper learning his lesson, being like, okay, if I don't do anything at this point, I'm going to die to up B. So he presses the ejector button and manages to only get the single coin, because he manages to ship his hurtbox just enough to not get the sweet spot.
Dude, just a second ago, I just saw that both of them just like walking in sync, just back, but like, hey, yeah, let's just go stroll through the park before Thanksgiving dinner and stuff.
All right, now both players are looking for their kill options. Oh, no, he read that option and tried going for the down B in order to, like, beat it out.
Oh, but he just did it again.
Yeah.
He will never expect this.
A second time. I feel like that's just, like,